Hey guys, welcome back to the canteen. It's Stephanie, your friendly neighborhood barkeep. Please remember to subscribe, hit that bell so you know when I upload more content. Please remember to hit that like button, smash it, and share away here. We share away here for love Star Wars. And here comes.
Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is Stephanie. Please feel free again to, you know, pull up a bar stool if you haven't already. Third video of the day, and I am going to do all three videos. One of my Twitter friends, who goes by the handle That's Not How the Force Works, posted a very interesting string of tweets yesterday, basically explaining why she thinks Han and Leia are Rey's parents. And there's a lot in there that I've got the Force Awakens novel, I kind of looked through it, but I didn't go through all of it. And it's very interesting how you start to see some of the connections that you didn't realize were there. These are my reasons why. The Falcon, she can fly the Falcon. She gets along with Han. There's a bond there with Han, and it's not some mentor, whatever thing that Luke had with Obi-Wan. It's more father and daughter. It's more father and child. It's very compelling. Han being asked by Maz, who's the girl? And we don't get to hear the whole. I would really like to see the whole scene because I think JJ cut it off too soon, again, like he always does. Rey's force back vision. In the novel, there's a scene where she remembers standing in the forest and someone says to her, "Just wait right here, sweetheart. I'll be right back." The only person in Star Wars to ever use the word sweetheart is Han. Right? Very interesting. So that leads you to wonder if she was kidnapped when Han lost the Falcon, or which could be a very sort of, you know, you jump into that, or she was, but here's my thing, here's the, and that does work, but it doesn't explain how she's at the academy when Kylo Ren goes up and starts, or maybe the Knights of Ren attacked a village that she was in. She was running away. Something happened. She was kidnapped with the Falcon, and she ended up on Jakku with the Falcon. Ended up with the Falcon. And Kylo Ren happened to find her in a village that they were looking for dissidents and recognized her and then left her on Jakku. Because to me, in that, when she's standing in the rain and she's facing the Knights of Ren, she's being approached. And one of the, you know, Knights of Ren raises his lightsaber to kill her, and Kylo Ren kills him and then approaches her, and then she's on Jakku. What does all that mean? But a lot of it, like the concept art where she's dressed as Han, she's literally wearing the dark jacket with a sleeve slit. And I'll put the picture on in the video. The dark jacket, she's got the blaster and her lightsaber on her right side, and she's got Carillion blood stripes. And another piece of concept art, she and Leia are looking out across what looks like the crate hangar, and she's dressed like Han in a vest and boots. Chewie's, the fact that she knows Shriwook. We know that Shriwook is a very difficult language for people to understand, and we know from canon that Han was taught that by a Wookiee who took care of him named Mala. Go and read A.C. Crispin's novels. I am not acknowledging at all Solo in this at all. That is not, to me, that is not canon. What they did to Han was disgraceful. What they did to Lando was disgraceful, but we talked about that before. Learning Shriwook could be difficult. How does she know that? And of course, you know, Disney just gives a stupid, you know, Jason Fry wrote this dumb manual for Rey, how she knows all this shit. It's just garbage. It's just garbage because they're lazy and they don't want to have to actually do the right thing. And they don't like the OT and they don't like the prequels. So anyway, let's go further. Chewie has a bond with her. And Han doesn't get along with anybody when he first meets him. He doesn't trust people. He can't get along with Luke. He can't get along with Leia. but he's instantaneous bonded with this girl. Now, well, the way he treated his son, he didn't treat his son badly at all. That is, some dipshit Raylo cunts. I went there. Stupid headcanon. Okay. When you read Bloodlines, Kyle Ron was sent with Luke because he was getting to a point where he was a bit of a basket case. It sounds like a very angry boy. And he had, you know, force abilities. And, you know, they didn't know what to do with him. So they sent him off to Luke, who, I mean, he's a Jedi Master, who would help him. And hopefully get him to overcome all this Vader obsession. Well, we see how well that worked. Well, anyway, let's go further. So Han gets along with this girl. Why? All right, let's go back. I'll be back in a minute. Stay here, sweetheart. I'll be right back. She's standing in the woods. She remembers that. All right, so he gets along with her. He gives Rey, this girl who actually could fly a ship as well as he could, not better. Come on, guys. Come on, Phantom Menace. Stop giving Rey more than what she earned. She hadn't earned it, but we don't know why. And at least in The Force Awakens, there was a chip, just a little bit of a story that we could have worked with, explaining all this stuff and not going the way, by the way, the Mary Sue shit. Han gives her a very fatherly gesture of giving her a blaster. This is before she even saw Anakin's lightsaber. There's a scene in the movie Lonesome Dove, the novel Lonesome Dove, Pulitzer Prize novel Lonesome Dove, and the miniseries, which is a fantastic show. If you like good storytelling, it is excellent. Watch it, starring Tommy Lee Jones and Robert Duvall, Diane Cannon, and Angelica Houston. Anyway, there's a scene in the first episode where Woodrow walks up to this boy that's working for him, Woodrow Cawley. He's a former Ranger captain, a Texas Ranger, and gives a big old Navy Colt to this boy, Newt, who's played by Ricky Schroeder. And he's just kind of looking at it, and he goes, it's better to have it and not need it than need it and not have it. And what they were going to do was they were going to go screw around in Mexico that evening and steal a bunch of cattle and horses and bring them back to Lonesome Dove to either sell, or Woodrow started to get an idea. He wanted to go to Montana, drive a herd of cattle to Montana and start the first ranch there. Okay. So that we end up discovering that Woodrow is actually Newt's dad. So let's go back to Star Wars. Giving that blaster to Rey means something that is symbolic, that is a fatherly gesture. It's not the same as giving Anakin's lightsaber to Luke, because that's Obi-Wan, the mentor, giving the dad's lightsaber to the son. This is a little more than that. So anyway, let's go further. Han, in the IMAX version, tells Leia, there's something I've got to tell you. Leia says, wait till you get back. Before he goes to Starkiller Base. We get to Starkiller Base, and here's where it gets very interesting. What did Han and Leia talk about? There were conversations we never saw. But when Rey escapes and she's out of there and they're looking for her and, you know, Finn's like, we've got to find her. And Han does this like that. And all of a sudden Finn turns and he's like, over there, look. And Finn turns around and sees Rey going up the wall. You see Finn go forward, but the camera pans back to Han. That look is one of recognition. I know who you are, right? And it is the prideful look of a father looking at his daughter, okay? It could be an uncle, but that look means a lot. Ford doesn't give a lot away, but that's exactly the look. And it looks like a dad watching his daughter and remembering seeing another woman doing crazy shit, Leia. That's you know, Leia, the woman who killed Jabba, right there as, you know, of their daughter. So when they run into Rey, and Rey is like, you came back for me, and Chewie basically says in his Chewbacca way that it was Finn's idea. And Finn goes, what did he say? And she says, he said it was your idea. Again, how the hell does she know Shuri woke? Oh, and the deleted scene where Unker Plett suddenly shows up at Maz's cantina and tries to intimidate Rey to give back the Millennium Falcon. Not realizing the actual real owner of the Falcon is there with his Wookiee co-pilot. And Chewbacca comes up and very protectively rips Unker Plett's arm out of his socket. Why would Chewie want to protect a girl he doesn't know? All right, Chewbacca's life debt when Han and Leia began their relationship also went to Leia. The princess, you have to take care of her, okay? That meant any progeny they have, okay? That didn't mean Ben Solo because Ben's a jackass, okay? And Ben, you know when times it's time to give up on somebody and you know, you can't enable that shit anymore. So let's go further. So when we get back to Dakar and the resistance base, Leia bypasses Chewie. Now JJ said he forgot about that, which is bullshit. There was a reason why he did what he did. JJ's also lying. Leia goes up and she and Rey hug each other. It is then an auntly hug. The ring that she's wearing in her right hand, on the right ring finger, is a mother's finger. My mother owned one. 9 stones for 9 different children. Leia's has 2 stones. They're both connected to 2 different kids. And it's front and center when she hugs her. And then when she really bears into it and pulls her close, that is a motherly hug. All right. And in the novel, it said motherly hug. When Rey goes to go find Luke, she's fussing with her jacket like a mom would. Maybe an old aunt, but a mom. It's very interesting, that whole thing. And I do believe in the novel and in the movie, JJ was setting it up. Now, was Rey taken along with the Falcon? That actually does make sense now when I think about it. Was she at Luke's Jedi Academy? How did she get to a place where Kylo Ren would see her? All right, that's a thing we don't understand, okay? Now, maybe JJ basically abandoned all of it. He had a good setup and, you know, he basically said, fuck it, I'm gonna do what I want. And the Vanity Fair article, I don't know. So let's go to TLJ. Well, we have Rey walking on the cliffs and hearing the voice on the wind. And the only person I know that heard it at the theater is Mark with the C. But the voice says, you are his salvation, you are his niece, say it. And you can hear the girl saying it into the microphone. Get to the cave. Show me my parents. You see a tall, lanky man, and that's the Ford Solo haircut, and a tiny woman in a gown. And they morph into one, and it looks like the man, or at least some male figure, walks forward and puts his hand up on the other side of the mirror. And all Rey sees is herself. That is the lazy way of doing Luke's fight with himself in the cave on The Empire Strikes Back. When Luke and Leia have that force bond and she wakes up from a coma, instantly you go to Kylo Ren and Rey having their force bond. And then at the end, after Luke basically helps everybody escape and they all get onto the Falcon, what's left of the Resistance, there's the force bond there. And as Kylo Ren sees his father's gold dice, which, why the hell is Disney bringing that up anymore? It is absolute utter fucking bullshit. And they're both staring at each other. And Rey gives what I would say that Solo glare. and slams the door of the Falcon on Kylo Ren and they leave. The symbolic image is this. He's being abandoned by his family. You have Rey with mom, dad's ship, his blaster, and grandpa's lightsaber still trashed, but she saved it. And the books from the Force Tree, the temple in an alcove above where Rose Tico's in her coma, because everybody has a coma now in Star Wars. So do I think that Rey, and this is why I do think that they are brother and sister, and why I think Palpatine wants her is because she's actually more powerful in the Force than Kylo Ren is. And that's what I think is going on. That's what I think, and I hope that JJ goes with it, because and why there's a bond between them, Kylo Ren and Rey, is because they're both from the exact same bloodline. Okay, now people say, why didn't Leia tell her? Well, let's put it this way, maybe Rey already knows now. Maybe Rey's already figured it out. We don't know. We don't know how that reveal is going to happen. It'd be better to do a flashback to Leia telling her, or to, you know, when you look at the trailer, you see Leia with, obviously it's Han's metal, running her hand over it, and it's obviously Leia holding it, and then hugging, and that hug. So, yes, Rey is, you know, they call it the Rise of Skywalker, and then you've got concept art of Luke standing there amongst ruins of something burning with R2 that looks a little small. And what's really weird is that he's got a glove on his hand. I don't know. All I know is I think what JJ intended to do is make them brother and sister. It makes sense in the saga form. It echoes back to Luke and Leia. The fact that Anakin's grandkids would be the dark and light side of the same coin would make perfect sense. And it would be something that Lucas, I think, in his own idea for the sequel, would want. You know. So there you go. And, you know, it also gives Han a little more, I think, pathos in why he didn't go home to Leia. It gives him more reason not to. And it's not because she is the love of his life. He is the love of her life. But the idea that not only he lost his ship, but maybe their daughter, would be something that would profoundly affect him as a man. You'd have to understand the character, okay? Does JJ understand the character? I mean, he said Han is his favorite character. Does he understand him? I don't know. By the way, I just kind of wanted to give, that's not how the Force works, her just do, because she did a really good job explaining it. And I'll see her on the Galaxy Scoundrel, so you know what to do. See you later. Hey guys, hope you enjoyed the video. Sorry it was so long, and I'll be back later with another one, maybe today. And I hope you enjoy your afternoon. This is Steph. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. Hit that bell for more content. Please remember to hit that like button and share away if you love Star Wars. And I will see you around the galaxy.